Hello, everyone. This is Dan Rexroth, president of John Knox Village, and I'm here today with Gail Benet, who's president of the John Knox Village Foundation. And Gail, we're going to talk about all things foundation. And this summer, we were going to have a gala. Isn't that right?
That is absolutely right. We were looking forward to having our fifth annual gala in July, and the theme was going to be Let's Fiesta. We were so excited about it, and we had decided back in January that we were going to be raising money for two new buses for the village. And
yeah, so we just canceled it, I guess, right? What happened? I mean, was there something? Was the pavilion booked that night, or was there some other reason? I can't remember why we had to cancel the gala.
We had pandemic over the summer.
Oh, a pandemic.
Yes, I don't know if you read about that or
not. I had heard about that. I think I read it in the newspaper. That's right. So we had to cancel because of the pandemic.
Yes.
Okay, so, well, that means then that we couldn't raise any money, right? How can you raise money when you have to cancel the event?
You know, that occurred to me too. I was a little nervous when we decided to cancel the gala because everybody loves a party. Our vendors have come out for the past 5 years and helped us raise significant dollars for different projects. But I was thinking about this a few minutes ago. When we first started planning for the gala and we were raising money for the buses, it was all about we needed more buses. Our buses were old and needed to be repaired or replaced. But as the pandemic hit us and as things changed for our residents, the meaning became so much different for me. It became not just about replacing and adding a bus. And that's where we came up with the theme On the Road Again. It became something for our residents to look forward to.
All right.
Something that we wanted to be able to give them as a gift after we get through this terrible time, and we want to be able to get them on the road again.
Okay, so you have to cancel the gala, big event, huge party, band, food, prizes, all kinds of things. So how in the world do you raise money if you don't have a big event like that?
Well, the first thing we did was we went to our vendors. Those were the businesses who had supported us in the past, and we asked them if they would support us again this year, and we explained the situation, and they were generous. They were very generous in their gifts, and almost all of them chose to support this campaign. But I will tell you, the reason that I get so emotional when I talk about it is the incredible outpouring of generosity from our residents and our associates. Mm. They truly have come forward with beautiful gifts and notes of support. And so many times I've talked to people and they've said, "We just can't wait until you tell us that we've raised enough money that we can order two buses and we can start planning for that day."
Wow, so you just sent letters out to vendors, contacted residents, associates, people in the community that have supported us before, and let them know that we were just going to try and raise the money without a party, ask for their help. Well, so you've been collecting money over the last few months.
We have. We set a goal of $150,000, and that is what Brian Apoka said he needed to order two new buses.
Okay, so $150,000. Mm-hmm. Wow, two new buses. Brand new shiny buses with the John Knox logo.
Right.
Wow, so $150,000, that seems like a lot of money for people just to say, "Oh, I got a letter, I'm gonna send in a big check." So I'm sure there's no way we got to that goal, but can you tell us how we did?
Well, we did extremely well. We actually wrote a grant proposal to Bank of America, one of the trusts that they manage. We asked them for $50,000. They told us they probably couldn't do 50, but they would do something. And I was really hoping that between what the residents and the associates and vendors had done and a small amount from that foundation that we would be able to hit $150,000.
Which is a big stretch goal. Yeah, I mean, if I think about the other fundraising events that I go to in Lee's Summit and even in the greater Kansas City area, That's a big event. That's a big fundraising goal. That's a stretch goal for
most. It was considering we weren't having a gala, so we don't have the auction, right. We don't have the events that take place during the evening and things like that.
Yeah,
so
it was an ambitious
goal.
Right. So, well, I think everybody's waiting with bated breath to hear how you did, and you know, I'm just confident you probably didn't quite get there, but tell us how you did.
Well, I am very pleased to announce that as of today, we have raised $190,000.
Wow. Wait a minute. I thought I heard you say $190,000. Could that be right?
That is right. We received a $50,000 grant from Bank of America, which was more than we had expected. But more importantly than that, our vendors and our residents and our associates came through with $140,000 themselves.
Wow.
So it's incredible. I'm so grateful.
Lots of participation from lots of residents out there.
Yes.
Associates pitched in.
Right.
Vendors, community. Wow.
Right.
And together we raised $190,000.
We had more than 150 individuals who participated in the campaign in addition to our vendors.
Oh, so my goodness. That's fantastic, that's very exciting, and I'm sure that the folks in transportation will be right on this. So tell us about the ordering of the buses and when we might be able to see those buses, and do you know any information on that yet?
I know a little bit of information. I visited with Brian Apoka, and he has been working with maintenance to decide what exactly we want to order. The $150,000 would have allowed us to purchase pretty basic vehicles. With this additional funding, we'll be able to upgrade some of the things on the bus, like more comfortable seating for residents. One thing that we can do is now the steps onto the bus are pretty steep and a little difficult to climb. With the additional funds, Brian can order something that will be easier for residents to get on and off the bus using those stairs. So
wow, sounds like Rolls Royce buses, maybe Mercedes-Benz,
maybe not quite.
Cadillac, Buick.
Nothing.
At least. So
he's looking for things that will make life and travel easier for
residents.
Yes,
okay.
Absolutely.
Maybe some extra features, some options, some add-ons that can really be more convenient.
Yeah.
And boy, aren't we anxious to get on the road again. What a great title for the campaign.
We are.
And I know the residents are anxious to get on those buses and go out to shopping and to restaurants, to wherever we're going out in the Kansas City area.
Mm-hmm. So. And it will take 4 to 6 months. Those buses are custom ordered to Brian's specifications, and so they will take a little time to construct. But I am anticipating that they will be here in the spring and that people will be ready to ride them. So, and
great.
I cannot wait for that day.
Great. Well, thank you, Gail. Thank you for your excellent leadership.
Thank you.
In spearheading this campaign and in raising all that money with no party, no gala. We just raised it, and people generously gave to this cause. What a great cause.
They did.
And thank you to all residents. Wow, so many of you participated. I think I heard 150.
Over
150 residents who participated in this. Together, we made it happen. You raised $190,000. We're going to be able to order two buses that are even going to have some extra special features. So we are excited. Hopefully you are also excited about that. And come next spring, we're going to have two new buses on the road. Thanks for all you do to help John Knox Village and the John Knox Village Foundation, which does so many great things for the village.